Now that we've figured out the area inside of a polar curve, or between two polar curves, we're going to figure out the length of a polar curve. Okay, the key is to think of a polar curve as a parametrized curve. Now, we've done this before. We've written everything in terms of parameter t, and we'd said let theta equals t and r equals f of t. And let's just skip a step, and let's just call our parameter theta itself. So you can write x and y in terms of theta, where, because r is some function of theta, we've got our polar curve r equals some function of theta. And you take that function, you plug it into the fact that x is r cosine theta and y equals r sine theta. And now you've got x and y in terms of theta. And then you can figure out the derivative of x and the derivative of y. Derivative of r cosine theta by the product rule is r prime cosine theta minus r sine theta. The derivative of r sine theta is r prime sine theta plus r cosine theta, where r prime just means dr d theta. Okay? And then we square those. Dx d theta squared gives you a product of three terms. Dy d theta squared gives you a product of three terms. And you notice that the cross term exactly cancels. The cross term that you get from dx d theta is minus 2rr prime sine theta cosine theta. And the thing you get from dy d theta is plus 2rr prime sine theta cosine theta. So when you add the two things up, when you look at dx d theta squared plus dy d theta squared, it really simplifies. The r prime squared cosine squared plus r prime squared sine squared just gives you an r prime squared. The r squared sine squared plus r squared cosine squared just gives you r squared. And these other terms cancel. So you get that dx d theta squared plus dy d theta squared is just r prime squared plus r squared with no thetas left over. And now we know how to figure out arc length. Our formula for arc length from parametrized curve is we had to take dx dt squared plus dy dt squared, all square rooted, integrate dt. Well, now our parameter is called theta instead of t. We take it from our starting value of theta to our ending value of theta. And that just becomes the integral of r squared plus dr d theta squared, all square rooted, d theta. Okay, so that's the formula. So let's see how that works. Let's figure out the length of a cardioid. And actually, we're not going to quite figure out the length of a cardioid. We're going to figure out the length of half of a cardioid. If you want to figure out the length of a cardioid, take this, the answer we're about to get, and multiply it by 2. So we're going to figure out this half of the cardioid. And now I've written the cardioid sideways. I've written it as r equals 1 plus cosine theta instead of the usual r equals 1 plus sine theta. So instead of having an upside down heart, we have a sideways heart. And we're figuring out everything from here all the way to here. So we're going to integrate as theta goes from 0 to pi. Okay, so we just compute. R prime is minus sine theta, and r squared plus r prime squared is 1 plus cosine theta squared plus sine squared theta. And note, this is not 1 plus cosine squared theta, it's 1 plus cosine theta squared plus sine squared theta. We multiply the whole thing out. Cosine squared plus sine squared makes 1, so we get 2 plus 2 cosine theta. And now here comes the big deal. We know our double angle formula. Our double angle formula says cosine of twice anything is 1/2 of cosine squared of anything is 1/2 of 1 plus cosine of twice that anything. So when you have 1 plus cosine of something, you can replace it by twice cosine squared of half that angle. So cosine squared theta over 2 is 1 half of 1 plus cosine theta. Now here we don't have 1 half of 1 plus cosine theta, we have twice 1 plus cosine theta. So we get 4 cosine squared theta over 2. And the nice thing about 4 cosine squared is it's easy to take the square root of that. So what we want is we want to have the integral from 0 to pi of the square root of r squared plus r prime squared. And that's the square root of 4 cosine squared theta over 2. And that's twice cosine theta over 2. You would really need twice absolute value of cosine theta over 2, but between 0 and pi, theta over 2 is between 0 and pi over 2, and the cosine is positive. If you wanted to go from 0 to 2 pi, you would need the absolute values. 2 cosine theta over 2, integral of that is 4 sine theta over 2, evaluated at 0 and at pi, and the answer is 4. So the length of half the cardioid is 4, the length of the entire cardioid is 8.